Hi all, myself Shuhaib Said Muhammad, Director, RACE Institute of Advanced Learning and iSolutions Education Career Help Desk. In this video, our students, the RACEans, are going to present the topic Our Government, which is the fourth chapter of Kerala Syllabus Social Science 8th Standard. So let's watch the video.
Hello all, good morning. Myself Hanna, I am studying in RACE Institute of Advanced Learning. Today, I am going to speak on the organs of government. We all have organs, right? Our organs together perform to maintain a healthy body. Likewise, government also have organs. Government have three organs, which is legislature, executive and judiciary. So, let me explain each organ briefly. First one, legislature. Legislature is where a law is made. So, a bill is getting transferred to a law. Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and President take place in the making of law. Next one is executive. Executive is where a law is implemented. And President, Vice President, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers, bureaucracy, etc. take part in implementing law. Next one is judiciary, which is interpreting law. And in the judiciary, Supreme Court, High Court, District Court, Sub Court, Municipal Court, Magistrate Court, etc. take place. The legislature of India is known as Parliament. There are upper house and lower house in Parliament. So it is a bicameral legislature. Thank you all.
RACE Institute of Advanced Learning.
Myself Al-Sabit from RACE Institute of Advanced Learning. Today I am going to say about the important functions of Indian President. The important functions of Indian President are appoint Prime Minister and other ministers, appoint Chief Justice and Judges of the Supreme Court, nominate 12 members of the Rajya Sabha and 2 members of Lok Sabha, act as the supreme commander of armed forces, give assent to bills passed by the parliament, take decision in mercy petitions, declare emergency in the country if needed. Thank you.
RACE Institute of Advanced Learning.
Hi, I'm Hadia A.S. of RACE Institute of Advanced Learning and Technology. We, the 8th standard students, have a chapter in our social science part 1, Our Government. In that chapter, I would like to speak and introduce you about the topic Lok Sabha. Before knowing our Lok Sabha, we should know about our Parliament. The legislature in India is known as Parliament. It consists of the President and the two houses, namely Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. The Rajya Sabha is known as the upper house, lower house is Lok Sabha. Since it has two houses, it is namely bicameral legislature. We can move to our topic. Our topic is Lok Sabha. In Lok Sabha, there are 543 directly elected members and 2 nominated members. Lok Sabha is also known as House of Representatives and it is elected for a term for 5 years. And this Lok Sabha is presided over by the Speaker. Thank you, I'm concluding my words. Thank you, have a nice day.
For admission inquiries, please contact 944-738-9685.
Hi all, I am Amina Mohammed from RACE Institute of Advanced Learning, Kollam. I am an 8th standard student and I am here to talk to you about that how a bill passes. Do you know what a bill means? A law in the draft term is called as bill. And the next, the house which considered the bill first is called as first house and the second is called as second house. And the first house is Lok Sabha and the second house is Rajya Sabha. The first stage of considering a bill to a law is first reading, second reading and third reading. A first reading means that introducing the bill to the members on Lok Sabha. The second reading means that each and every article in the bill will either passes, changed or rejected. In the third reading, it will be passes or rejected. If it is passing the bill from the first house by the certificate of presiding officer, it will be going to the second house by the same procedure, just like first reading, second reading and third reading. If it is passes from the second house, it will be gone to the president. By the approval of president, it comes to a law. And this is how a bill comes to a law. And thank you, Bias. I'm concluding.
RAISE Institute of Advanced Learning.
Myself, Hadia Safar from RAISE Institute Advanced Learning. Today, I'm going to talk about money bill. What is money bill? What is the process of money bill is different from that of an ordinary bill? Let us discuss. Any bill is related to the collection of revenue or expenditure from the consolidated fund can termed as money bill. The constitution states that the money bill can only introduced by the Lok Sabha. After the bill is passed by the Lok Sabha, it is sent to the Rajya Sabha with the certificate of speaker that the bill is a money bill. The Rajya Sabha must return the money bill with along the recommendation to the Lok Sabha within a time period of 14 days. The Lok Sabha can accept or reject the recommendation of the Rajya Sabha. That's all and thank you.
RAISE Institute of Advanced Learning.
I myself am Patra from RAISE Institute of Advanced Learning. I am here to deliver a lecture about Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha or Council of State is the upper house of the bicameral parliament of India. It currently has a maximum membership of 245, of which 233 are elected by the legislatures of state and union territories using single transferable votes through open ballots, while the president can appoint 12 members for their contribution to arts, literature, science and social services. The potential capacity of Rajya Sabha is 250, 238 elected and 12 nominated, according to Article 80 of Indian Constitution. Members sit for staggered terms lasting for 6 years with elections every year, but almost a third of the 233 designated up for the election for 2 years, specifically in even numbered years. The Rajya Sabha meets in continuous session, and unlike the Lok Sabha being the lower house of parliament, Rajya Sabha, which is the upper house of parliament, is not subjected to dissolution. The Rajya Sabha is presided over by the Vice President and he is the ex-officio chairman of India. And our current Vice President is Venkaiah Naidu. Thank you and have a nice day.
For admission inquiries, please contact 9447389685.